This is Cactus Jim. I'm going to speak one of my poems here with the music of Sonny Rollins in the background. It's from this CD. I do not own the copyright to Sonny Rollins' music, obviously. So here it goes. This is called Last Night on the Deck. I'm sitting out on the deck above the harbor in Cape Island, New Jersey. About to embark on a trip back to Tucson, Arizona. Last night on the deck, above the asphalt, so conflicted, about 100 miles of highway home, past all the unknown places, Clinton, Oklahoma, and a cheap $2.99 chicken dinner with dessert. All the forgotten fried catfish plates in Texas. Poetry on a plate with a gram of grease. The woman waits, walking the fence of love and hate. So conflicted is this old hippie, and the road's been way too long. Way, way too long. You just go around and around with your life, and you end up painting pictures like this one. Now that my flesh is falling off the bone, I hate Texas like the truckers do. 825 miles from Beaumont to El Paso. That unfolds like my 66 years of life, which would have been better spent on Route 66. The Mother Road. It was once fun to drive the blue highways. Well, now I just get blue. On the interstates that Eisenhower had to have, much faster than the blue highways. Fast like the crappy lives we live in a rush. And all the roads. Lead to the grave sooner or later. We live our lives as if each day were worth a dollar instead of $10,000. On our deathbeds, what would we pay for another day? If we lived forever, would our lives have more meaning or less? Are my dead parents happy or disappointed that heaven is a joke? With the same Walmart-type stores. There are too many people, both dead and alive. The afterlife must look like I-95 at rush hour. Bumper to bumper, coffin to coffin. William Bradford, a teacher, was convicted of killing another teacher and her 11-year-old daughter. He was sentenced to prison. Bradford knew the poet Ezra Pound. He had books inscribed to him from Ezra Pound. I looked at the books. His girlfriend was trying to sell them. She claimed he was innocent. Well, we're all innocent, aren't we? All guilty. So if Bradford were innocent, he'd still probably be dead by now. Even the real killer is now dead or living in Argentina. Eventually, everyone will be dead, including the prison warden and groundskeeper, and Martin Heidegger, who spoke so eloquently of death over a 9-course meal. He's very much cold and dead, as well as all the meals we eat, which are dead before we consume them. Dead chicken, dead fish, dead turkeys, dead vegetables, and perhaps I came to Cape Island to understand what all this means while eating dead sandwiches and dead bluefish, dead sea bass, dead crabs, smoked salmon on a bicycle. I'm like this midnight cowboy who goes where the weather suits his clothes. I'm enamored of climate more than love. I can't hold a job if it's cold there in December. My bones seek the tropic and jasmine and enough women to go around. I can't have sex if there's ice on the windshield. What about you, brother?